Let's say that you have a document that requires Roman numerals in one section and Arabic numerals in another section. What do you do? No worries. Word makes changing number styles easy with section breaks. But first, a caveat. Before writing any long document, be sure to acquire the template for it from your instructor, your department, or your school, especially for theses and dissertations. Now, that said, this page numbering technique works for any document, regardless of length or complexity. Okay, here we go. Step one, scroll through your document and determine where page numbering changes are going to happen. Most often, the two main sections are front matter and body. Front matter consists of any page that comes before the body. Front matter can include title page, abstract, of course, acknowledgments, table of contents, very common, list of abbreviations, and so on. Now, the five pages of front matter in this particular document are its title page, its abstract, acknowledgments, table of contents, and this list of abbreviations. Now, these pages are put in order specified by this school. Now, the next section is the body. Body pages are numbered sequentially all the way to the end. Now, sometimes in dissertations or articles for publications, there's a third section, and that's called the back matter. This back matter can include any supplemental material, such as data sets, supplemental figures and tables, even audio and visual digital information. Now, this sample document has no back matter, which is very common. Okay, let's start numbering our document at the title page. It's the first page of our front matter, and we're told by the template we're using to use Roman numerals. No problem. Go to Insert, then Page Number, and in the drop-down menu, select Format Page Numbers. In the dialog box that appears, change the style to Roman numerals. Now, click on Insert Page Number again, and this time select top or bottom, left, middle, or right alignment, depending upon your template. For this school, I'm told to use top of page, right align. There. A Roman numeral 1 appears. But wait, you say, there shouldn't be a page number on the title page. That's usually true. However, Word will always recognize the first page of any document as page 1, and there's nothing you can do about it. Your only choice is to make that page number 1 implicit rather than explicit. Now, the way to make that page number disappear, or in other words, make it implicit, is to click on Different First Page in the Options tab. The number on the title page disappears. And as we scroll down, we see that the pages of the front matter are now numbered consecutively in the upper right, as our template says, with Roman numerals. Now, your next step is to insert a section break between this front matter and the next section, the body of your document. So first, we need to turn on formatting marks. So go to File and all the way down to Options. And in the window that appears after clicking on Options, select Display and then Show All Formatting Marks and then click OK. Now, go to the last page of the front matter, which in this document just happens to be the list of abbreviations. Again, we're using a template. And activate your cursor right before the last paragraph symbol on the page. Now you see why we turned on formatting. Then, click on the Layout tab, then on the Breaks drop-down menu. And under Section Breaks, select Next Page. Boom, the break is added. But note that an extra paragraph return or character may have been inserted. If so, delete it now. You don't need it. Now, activate your cursor again in the header footer area. And look at the break section between section 1 and section 2. Look on the right side for same as previous. That is Word's default setting, and it must be changed. You definitely don't want the two sections to be the same. That's why you're creating sections. You want to start new and different page numbering. So, go to the navigation grouping, look for link to previous. You want to disable this link by clicking on it, boom, once. Now, you can begin new page numbering. So with your cursor in the header or footer area, just go to Insert, Page Number, Format Page Numbers, because remember this section has Arabic numerals, so change the style to Arabic. And at the bottom of the dialog box under Page Numbering, click on Start At and enter number 1 to begin numbering your body pages with 1. That's it. If you have any back matter, just follow the same procedure of creating a good new section. All right, I wish you the very best success. Let me know however I can help going forward.